Hi, this is Yasir from WPHowKnow, and in today's video we will see how to install WordPress on 000webhost for free and how to access your WordPress website, its files and associated database. We will also see where you can find FTP information to connect to your website. Launching a WordPress website on 000webhost is very easy, as 000webhost provides WordPress installation in just one click. Yes, literally in just one click you can launch a complete WordPress website on 000webhost. But before going to that part, first a little bit information about 000webhost and its free plan. Basically, 000webhost is powered by a hostinger company. 000webhost provides free services, while all the paid plans are handled by hostinger company itself. In 000webhost free web hosting plan, you can create one website up to 300 MB in size and with monthly bandwidth limit of around 3 GB. In free web hosting plan, you will not get any email account or support from 000webhost. In short, we can say that this free hosting plan is good for practicing purposes. Now let's see how to install WordPress on 000webhost for free. But before we continue, please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can keep getting our content regularly. First of all, let's go to 000webhost.com and click on sign in button. If you already have an account on 000webhost, you can log in by entering your credentials here. If not, you can log in by using either your Facebook account or your Gmail account. Or you can also set up a new account using your email address by clicking the sign up button here. We will use the Gmail account to log in, so we will click on login with Google button. From here, select the account with which you want to log in. After selecting the account, you will automatically log in into your 000webhost account. From here, click on let's create some magic button and it will start a wizard. Or you can skip the wizard if you want. In wizard, first it will ask you what you would like to do on 000webhost. You can select any option from here. We are selecting other option here. Now it will ask you to enter a name and password for your website. This name field is optional, and if you do not enter any name here, 000webhost will create a random name for your website itself. Actually, it will be a subdomain name that will be assigned to your website. Let's say if we select WPHowKnow name for our website, then our website address will be WPHowKnow.000webhostapp.com. And if you already have a domain name, you can connect that to this website. But we are not going to cover that in this video. After selecting the name, set a strong password here, and it will also be used as the password for the FTP account. After that, click on submit button here. Now 000webhost will give you three different options to create the website. If you want, you can use the website builder provided by 000webhost to create the website, or you can create a website by uploading the website files that you may already have. Since we want to create a WordPress website, so we will select install WordPress option from here. Now it will ask you to set the username and password for your WordPress website, and you will need these credentials to log in into your WordPress website. So remember these credentials as you will need them in the upcoming steps. After setting up the credentials, click on install button. Now the installation of WordPress will start, and it will take a while to complete the process. Meanwhile, please take a moment to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Now WordPress and your website has been installed successfully, and to access your newly created WordPress website dashboard, click on Go to Configuration page. And this is the login page of your WordPress website. If you see the address bar, you can see the name of your website, which in our case is wphowknow.000webhostapp.com. And whenever you want to get to the login page, enter wp-login.php after the website name, and you will be redirected to the login page on which we are already present. Before logging into the dashboard, first let's see the front end of our newly installed website. copy the website name and paste it into a new tab. This is the front end of the website on which a WordPress theme has been installed automatically. Now to access the dashboard of your WordPress website, enter the credentials that you had set while installing the WordPress. After entering the credentials, click on login button. Now you are in the dashboard of your WordPress website. Explore it a little bit to get familiar with it. For example, to see which themes are installed and which one is currently active on your website, go to the theme section under appearance. Here you can see all the themes that are installed on your website and which theme is currently active. You can also install new themes by clicking on add new button here. Same is the case with plugins. In the plugin section, you can see all the plugins that are installed on your website and you can easily activate or deactivate any plugin of your choice. And you can also install new plugins by clicking the add new button here. Now to see actually where all of your WordPress files are located, go to 000webhost account page and click on my sites button. And then click on manage website. It will take you to the dashboard of your 000webhost account. Here you can see the quota that is allocated to your website. Now to see the files that are associated with your website, click on file manager under files section and click on upload files button. It will redirect you to the file manager and here you can see two folders, public HTML and temp. Open the public HTML folder. Here all the files and folders are related to your WordPress website. And this folder WP-content is very important as it contains all of your themes, plugins and media files that you upload. Let's open this folder. Here the folder named themes contains all of your installed themes and their files, and the plugins folder contains all the plugins that are installed on your website. And all the images, videos and other files that you will upload from your WordPress will be present in the uploads folder. This was a short introduction to the files and folders that were related to your website. Now let's see the database that is connected with your website, and that database will contain all of your website's content like posts, pages and settings of themes and plugins in different tables. To access the database, once again go to dashboard of your 000webhost account and from here click on phpMyAdmin under databases section. This is the name of the database that is connected with your website. Now to explore it, click on phpMyAdmin under manage button. Now to see all the tables that are present in your database, click on database that is associated with your WordPress website. Here you can see all the tables that are associated with the WordPress website. Different tables will contain different information based on their functionalities. Now let's see where to find FTP information that you can use to connect to your website. For that, once again go to dashboard of your 000webhost account and click on website settings and then click on general. Here you can see the FTP details that are required to connect to your website. Here the password that you will use for FTP connectivity will be the password that you had set while creating the website. If you forget that password, you can change the password by clicking the change password button here. You can also find a bunch of other settings related to your website on this page, so go ahead and explore them. That's all for this video, and if you find this video useful, please hit the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button below. If you have any questions regarding the WordPress setup on 000webhost, let us know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.